Well, Merry Christmas! I'm your blue Valentine, Ryan Gosling.
Oh, thank God.
I came dressed as a blue Valentine. This is what a blue Valentine looks like.
Thank you so much. You're the only one that really cared enough to...
Yeah, to send the very best. And I'm also the Oscar messenger, so I'm here to tell you, you could be going to the Oscars, young sir.
Oh, boy.
Your performance in Blue Valentine is that good. And you've been there before, so, you know, you're in their wheelhouse, as they call it. The Oscar wheelhouse. But you're one of our greatest young actors, and it's a great honor and a thrill to meet you.
Oh, thank you.
So this movie, great stuff.
Thanks. What'd you think?
I loved it. But you should talk. Got me talking for 3 minutes, and then she only talked for once.
What do you think happened? What happened to the love? Where did it go?
Oh, man. Well, he was addicted. Wasn't he an alcoholic in the end, really?
Interesting.
You cannot be in love with somebody who's got the kind of addiction going.
Mm-hmm.
It's, you love the addiction more than you loved her.
Huh.
You're the booze. That's what I got.
That's cool. You know? That's interesting.
Anyway, would you want to talk about method acting and how you approach this?
I'm more interested in what you think of the film, but we could talk about whatever you want.
Yeah, well, as long as you say something, because the fans will want to...
Right. I think what's interesting about this movie, why I love it so much, is that it's not pretending to know everything, you know. This is the filmmaker, you know. Even when I read the script 5 years ago, it's just all it was asking was questions, and it made me ask questions of myself. And through the entire process of making it, all the director did was ask us what we think, and I think that that's what the movie does. And it's, I think, you know, you watch people come out of the film and they all have completely different takes on what happened, you know. It's almost like, I've been thinking of it as like a murder mystery, you know. In the beginning of the film, you realize that someone has shot down this beautiful couple's love in cold blood, and you're trying to figure out who's the killer. And so you're kind of retracing their steps, and you're trying to figure out, is it him, is it her, was it time, was it their upbringing, you know, was it the kid? But who killed it? And everyone's got a different answer, you know?
Yes, but that's what makes it so interesting. And I'm a playwright myself, so maybe someday I can write something for you. I have friends. I'm going to mention a couple of friends of mine who you've never met and you never heard of them. But they're obsessed with you. They're two straight guys that live in Toronto, which is where you're from, right?
Yeah,
they just did this comic book called Kill Shakespeare.
Okay.
And it's this huge success. It won the Pitch This contest at TIFF this year.
Oh, wow.
And they said, I said, who do you want to play Hamlet? And they said, oh, Ryan Gosling. Do you know him? And I said, no, but I'll mention it. And it's going to be a major feature film. So you may hear from these guys, and it's a brilliant comic book if you see it. It's got all the Shakespearean characters fighting to save Shakespeare. Oh, it's terrific stuff. It's out now.
Oh,
Kill
cool.
Shakespeare. Yeah, they told me to mention it, and I didn't think I'd have the time. But
if I do it, do you get 10%? Is that what this is
I
about?
Don't think so. No,
is that your angle?
Nice emails
I see.
From him.
Uh-huh.
Connor McCreary and Anthony Del Call, Kill Shakespeare. Okay, yeah. Oh, man. And they said, oh, we can get to Ryan Gosling. He's from
You're
Toronto.
A good friend.
He'll do this. So I thought, you know, I know this is such a difficult movie to talk about because it's such a painful topic, you know, the breakup of a relationship, the end of love.
Right.
I, unfortunately, had been there in this trip far too many times in my own life. So, but I could relate.
Oh, good.
You know.
Right.
And I loved him.
Who were you? Which one were you?
Michelle.
You were Michelle's character.
Of course. Don't look like her. I was the first person to tell Michelle that she was going to get nominated for an Oscar back in the Brokeback days. So
oh, yeah.
Her and Ethan, you know.
Uh-huh.
So tragic. Did you ever think you were reenacting that story?
No.
No.
I think this is wildly different from that experience, you know. I think what's great about the film is that somehow it seems to have tapped into some kind of a universal experience, you know. Maybe it's not as that bad or that specifically, but that it does kind of, you know, because I think it tries to focus. Here's the thing. Okay, so I talked to some friends of mine who are married, and I said to them, "What's the, you know, what problems do you have with each other?" She said, "Well, when he does the dishes, he doesn't squeeze out the sponge, and he does all the dishes, and he still leaves all that dirty dishwasher in the sponge, and he's doing it just to." And she was sure that it was this passive aggressive act that he was trying to drive her nuts. secretly.
Everything you
he was
do
trying
will be held
to gaslight her, you know.
In a marriage, yeah.
And you know they're divorced now, and obviously, I mean, maybe it's about the sponge, you know. But I think that the sponge was a symbol for something more, and I think that this movie tries to focus on like why is it that those little things become such big things, and why can't we address the bigger issues? You know, why do we make these like, you know, mountains out of these little sponges.
And sponge you're Canadian, mountains. So I'm like so down with Canadians. I love Canadians. It's a
you
little
sound Canadian.
I know. I go there to the Toronto every year, 12 years, and they're giving me so many wind-up signs over here. I hate to leave, Ryan, but
oh,
anyway.
I see.
Now that I just laid another franchise at your door,
yes.
Kill Shakespeare, they wanted to be the next Lord of the Rings in your Hamlet. So, okay, I did it. But anyway, Blue Valentine, you're going to the Oscars. Great meeting you. I'm your Blue Valentine, Ryan Gosling. Thanks so much, man.
I'm sad to see it end.
Not as sad as I am. Okay, all right, thank you.